Ezekiel 6:3 An in-house directory. For Christians on spiritual warfare to pull down the altars and high places. By Fritz Springmeier. Part 3 of 6. Oregon. The Bend area has an extremely strong hierarchy element. Many rich people have gone there, ritual sites are numerous in the area east and northeast and north of Bend. Bend, Oregon has several suburbs which are concentration points for where Illuminati members five. One of these is Bowery Lane, actually north of Bend off the main highway between Redmond and Bend, and also Broken Top Mountain. Some ritual sites in the area are Balancing Rocks, Castle Rocks, and the John Day Fossil Beds. The satanic hierarchy in Hend keeps their very secret rituals indoors in underground locations, except during the solstices. The fall solstice is done in eastern Oregon, but the spring solstice is done at Coos. One site for satanic rituals which is no longer used was a tornado-type cellar which was on Bowerly Lane just northwest of the mortuary and crematorium north of town. Another ritual site close to Bend was the Lava Tubes and Skeleton Cave which is 5 miles south of Bend. Apparently about 100 Illuminati men gathered there in their tuxedos in their Mercedes and Rolls Royces for a meeting. From Bend the Illuminati orders have been verbally transmitted to key centers. In our area, the Illuminati orders are coming into City Club. City Club is a semi-secret group who are the city's political insiders. City secretly runs our city of Portland. The Illuminati orders are verbally given about weekly to the leading witches, Satanists, and politicians. We will start with the Pacific Coast and work our way cast for the sake of covering things in a systematic way. The coastal area of Oregon is a chain of houses and beach ritual areas that the Satanists employ. In the north, are inside rituals Tia Astoria. Moving south along the coast between Manzanita and Rockaway are areas used for satanic rituals. And both towns are too. Depot Bay and Coos Bay are also areas of intense satanic ritual activity. Interestingly, Depot Bay is the site of a secret submarine base, and Coos Bay is the site of two active UFO bases. The third, east of Coos Bay, has been shut down. In Depot Bay, the coven uses a white louse on the east side of the main drag north of the jetty. South of Cows Bay near the area of Seven Devils Wayside and also Big Devil Gulch, high-level Satanism conduct their spring solstices. Southeast of Coos Bay as one moves into the forested hills and small towns there are lots of drug deals and witchcraft rituals being conducted in the area. In the coastal range west of Portland is another secret UFO base, and at Vernonia, the Satanists have a house for rituals. In between Newburgh and McMinnville is also a big house where a beautiful basement is used for satanic rituals. Eugene, where the University of Oregon is situated, is a hotbed of satanic coven activity. Another university town, Corvallis, Oregon, Oregon State, is the center of a great deal of New Age activity. Oregon has been the recipient of a great influx of hippies and New Age types from California during the last few decades. The major city north of Eugene between Eugene and Portland is Salem. As might be expected in a capital city, there is a great deal of occult and satanic activity in Salem. Illinois is east of Salem, where we run into the area of Gates, Oregon, where Jim Cole had a ranch for a satanic cult. Gates was an appropriate place, and the people of the Gates community had their community life centered around the Independent Order of Odd Fellows. Basically, the community life centered around that occult secret society, according to the only history ever written of the village, Gates of the North Santium, by Willis Grave, 1992 reprint of the 1988 copy, page 45. Gates is in between Salem and Bend on Highway 22. This is significant because for years the Illuminati gave instructions for a three-state area to their man in Bend who then relayed those instructions to places like Salem. Also east of Salem is Silverton, site of Lavis, Oregon headquarters for his Church of Satan. Knowing that waterfalls often are attributed to have special powers, I would expect that some groups are using Silver Creek Falls near Silverton for ritual, just like they use Niagara Falls, New York, and Multnomah Falls in Oregon's Columbia Gorge. Rituals have been performed at Silver Creek Falls and other sites in the mountains. Wizard Island in the middle of Crater Lake is a sacred site for pagan rituals. A farther east from Bend, is Burns, Oregon. In 1992, in the Alvord Desert in Harney County, a dozen people constructed a large star in the desert that covers 60 acres using 1,111 upright logs, at an overall cost of thousands of dollars and the donated time of 12 volunteer workers who helped the designer Bill Witherspoon. Bill also constructed a large Hindu meditation symbol in 1990. This is just one of a number of examples where people are constructing occult sacred sites around the country. Portland, Oregon. Because this author is from the Portland area, he is very well informed about the ritual sites in this area. The pattern of the ritual sites and satanic stronghold in the Portland or area is very typical of what one would find in any large U.S. metro area. The Illuminati and satanic covens have used funeral homes for rituals. An example is Finley's Mortuary and Crematorium just off Highway 26. The Illuminati and other occult groups have used the area hospitals for programming and rituals, for example, Freemasonry's Dürrenbecher Hospital for Children, including secret tunnels, the U.S. Veterans Hospital, including secret tunnels, and the Oregon Health Sciences University Hospital, including secret tunnels. The Jesuits, who are also Satanists, have used Providence Hospital along the Banfield Freeway. The Satanists use coffee shops, bookstores, and hard rock concert places to meet, recruit, and teach at. Examples of these include Panurge Emporium Store, 1005 NW 16, Satanic Ritual Paraphernalia, Robes, Athames, etc., and Bookstore. The store attendant waits on customers with a python snake wrapped around her neck. The snake, a demonized familiar, is quite curious. He may stick his head close to yours while you try to shop. X-ray Cafe, used as a satanic meeting place and invites rock bands with Satanists as band members to play. The Third Eye, a witchcraft store, with Grateful Dead material, and some satanic stuff and an all-seeing eye over its front door. Atlantis Rising, witchcraft store with herbs, Aurora Books, occult bookstore, Jiffy Squid, coffee house now closed. The Howling Frog, a coffee shop still going in the 6th and Everett Street area of NW Portland. A movie house in Portland shows satanic movies every Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. The Theosophical Society in NW Portland has its regional headquarters building and its public occult library. Occult rituals go on in homes, of which two examples are 2804 NE 42nd and 5931 SE Bush. The Church of Satan, whose local leader is Rex Church, is located in a large spooky house used for rituals at K9. Thompson Street, Portland. The Illuminati and other witchcraft groups like to use the large forested forest park near St. John's Bridge in Portland for ritual. The Illuminati controls Portland city government via a club called City Club. Instructions to the club from the Illuminati in London have been sent via couriers such as Hazel E. Billings, who would go to City Club as a speaker. Hazel Billings was a descendant of the generational occult family of Mary Baker Eddy. Hazel's husband and his father were Freemasons. Her instructions were forwarded via Findhorn in Scotland. Her instructions would then be given to City Club members such as Robert C. Bailoff, Bohemian Club MMBR. The City Club has had Satanists such as ex-mayor Bud Clark, a lewd bartender who became mayor, just replaced as mayor, and our current mayor Vera Katz, a witch. The Northwest U.S. Occult Area Board meets in Portland. It has some members of the Illuminati on its board at all times, although not all members are Illuminati. This secret area board represents and controls all the occult groups in this area. At one time it had the following members. Mrs. Wong of Salem. This woman is of the Lee family, one of the top 13 families. The Lee family has a proud occult heritage that goes back many centuries. They are experts in palmistry. This family also runs the Chinese mafia triad type societies in this area. Their mafia group is called the Tong. Father Bianco. This Jesuit was into the occult and has lived in my area of Portland. He worked with Providence Hospital at one time. During the 1950s, he was in the position of pastoral care at Providence. Judge Ringo, this top lawyer and judge, sat on the area board. The minister of the Unity Church on Stark St. Ptld. Very likely a Freemason. The woman who headed up the Science of Mind organization, which has branches on Hallgate in Portland, in Salem, and in California. Bob Bartel, sick-part of Tektronics, and lived in Hazeldale. This man held the patent for holographic images and was doing holographic research for Tektronics. Tektronics is tied in with the CIA. Dean. Part of the Bar Association. One of the corporate heads of OMARC. Ben Majesta, sick employed by Tektronics, was skilled in TM, taught people how to levitate, and had received the TM Ascended Master training. Some of the groups that they manage, including a New Age school in Wilsonville, the Odo, the Jesuits, Alpha Awareness seminars, which were given at Unity Church by people like Wally Vero Mento of MT, Shasta, California, Silva Mind Control, and Mormon Stakes, New Wiccan Church, Sister Spirit, Ancient Spirits, Shadows, in Wilsonville, the Theosophical Society, the Aquarian Church Universal, the Aquarian Light Center, East West College, Portland Waldorf School, the various Masonic groups, who have 80 special tax-exempt properties here in Portland. A group which calls itself Contemporary Christian Hermeticism, isn't Christian magic an oxymoron, has its Temple of Wisdom put on at the Catholic Franciscan Center, on SW Palatine Road in Portland. The young people here are caught up with satanic rock bands such as Grateful Dead, Coke Distributors, Iron Maiden, Kiss, We Are Satan's People, Wasp, and King Diamond. Strange activities go on in the string of establishments of the McMenamin family. Edgefield is just one occult, drug prostitution establishment. Other strange McMenamin establishments with occult art are the Blue Moon Tavern, the Baghdad Theater, and the Ham's Head. One of the most occultic schools is the public school in NW Portland called Metropolitan Learning Center. Their teachers do occult rituals in official teacher meetings, and the winter solstice play, which replaced anything to do with Christmas about 14 years age, is an occult ceremony that the children annually participate in. Several years ago, I exposed that the winter solstice play had children wearing barcodes on their foreheads during an extremely occultic ceremony. T-Mars took the information and did a front page story about it. This author's writing have repeatedly exposed how Mormonism has a strong contingent of Satanists in its leadership and membership. Mormon bishop warehouses you're used to store cocaine. Here in Portland, three ex-Illuminati witnesses have told me about the secret satanic ritual and programming and entertainment area that was built underneath the recently built Portland Mormon Temple in Lake Oswego. Entry to the underground site is accomplished by authorized people whose retinas and handprints are scanned. The most sophisticated technology has been used to hide this underground site. However, with three independent witnesses stating that Illuminati rituals go on underneath the Mormon Temple, their independent stories sound credible. Further proof is that all building records in Lake Oswego are to be public, but the city of Lake Oswego is keeping the Mormon Temple blueprint secret, which is in violation of their standards. The blueprints were also changed with the city of Lake Oswego's knowledge to hide what actually was built. A Christian witnessed that the blueprints got changed from what was actually built. Marie and Donnie Osmond are public examples of Mormon monarch slaves. Merrill Osmond works with the Illuminati. The patriarchal blessings are sometimes used by adept satanic Mormon patriarchs to hypnotize Mormons, to cue hoes who are programmed. A number of independent witnesses and a court case have provided evidence about how the Satanists are using the extensive maze of tunnels underneath the heart of downtown Portland. This is a whole subject in itself, but needless to say, the intelligence agencies, the Illuminati, the Satanic Hub, etc., all are aware of how to get into the tunnel system. The tunnel system was a grid until the city turned it into a maze by sealing off portions. The original system was built for Shanghaiing anyone who strayed into downtown Portland during the first 100 years of Portland's existence. People would be knocked out and dragged via the tunnels to ships, to provide sailors for the ships. Any disobedient sailor could be killed by his ship's captain's orders. The Chinese triads also built extensive additions to the tunnels for white slavery, prostitution, opium dens, and illegal gambling dens. The city government was in cahoots with both the Shanghaiing and the triads during its early history. One victim of Satanism claims that a tunnel line has been run from the Portland Tunnel south to Eugene. If so, the tunnel would parallel Interstate 5. Bull Run, near Mount Hood, Portland's drinking water relates to Illuminati activity in more ways than one. Portland gets part of its water from Bull Run reservoirs up toward me. Hood. A large area up around the reservoir is fenced off and guarded, supposedly to guard our water supply. Underground near the reservoir is a good-sized complex where the Illuminati are carrying out cloning, or at least were. As far as I know, the complex is still operating. Interestingly, a recent Oregonian The Major newspaper in this Urea News article said that cloning of animals was already happening, and that cloning of people was only a short time into the future. Of course, they didn't mention nor even hint that this is already being done only 20 miles from the suburbs of Portland in a secret underground complex. East of Portland in the Mount Hood area is a lake called Lost Lake where rituals are carried out. Actually, there are several sites in the region of Mount Hood which are used. Not only that, but in the Bull Run Reservoir area, which is closed to the public because it is a major source of Portland's water supply, the government working under Illuminati directions have built a super secret underground complex to do biological cloning. Seaside, Oregon and Newport Beach, Oregon have also been sites of satanic activity. Yachts, Oregon, which is just north of Devil's Elbow Street K. and Neptune Street PK, is the area that the satanic hierarchy is now using for their fall equinox rituals. Pennsylvania. Indian Echo Caverns. These caverns are considered sacred by the occult. The caverns are located 1 mile south of Hummelstown, PA. There are areas near the caverns where people camp. Philadelphia, home of the Pagan Way, a mystical pagan group, which became Taoists. State College, various occult groups in the area. Rhode Island. Unknown. South Carolina. Hilton Head, 8.c. The purpose of this article is to help reveal to Christians how the real political process works. There is an oft-quoted quote by Benjamin Disraeli, 1801-1884, who was Prime Minister of the world's greatest empire at the time, the British Empire, as follows: "You see that the world is governed by very different personages than what is imagined by those who are not themselves behind the scenes." Another insider said, "The world is divided into three kinds of people: a very small group that makes things happen, a somewhat larger group that watches things happen, and a great multitude that never knows what has happened." One big part of the process for the Illuminati in their selection of who they want to make president of the LS is what I will call meat markets. These are events that the potential puppets of the Illuminati are invited to so that the Illuminati talent scouts can compare and make selections about who they want to place into Syrian positions. Of course, they hedge their bets by running their people in all the parties which have major candidates. The story behind Hilton Head. Renaissance Week at Hilton Head, South Carolina, is one of the elite's meal markets. We will describe how Renaissance Week occurs and what happens during this week after a while. Let's first describe Hilton Head. Hilton Head Island is conveniently located just south of Parris Island along the southern coast of South Carolina. Parris Island is a major marine training facility, and the military activity hides secret intelligence activity for the elite. Across Port Royal Sound lies Hilton Head Island. Just a few miles further south is the Georgia border and the city of Savannah. Although Hilton Head Island is located only about 20 miles off of 1-95, it is a rather private area, while still close to some important items. The island has a nice international airport to land the jets of the elite. It is close to a labor market and supplies in Savannah, and it is close to government operations at Parris Island. The building on Hilton Island have been hidden on purpose. Book article describes this. Thanks to a painstakingly crafted tree ordinance, the town has been uncommonly successful in hiding its residential and commercial buildings behind screens of green. Gale, Bob. Hilton Head, The Cunopy View, American Forests, March-April 1990, p. 61, The city of Hilton Head has a very strict, complicated set of laws that require city citizens to hide their buildings behind and under trees and foliage. Further, the process of getting approval for any building requires such intense planning casts to a builder, that the area has protected itself from the lower classes moving in. The tree ordinance is strictly enforced by a natural resources administrator. Seclusion is one of attributes of Hilton Head that attracts the elite. An example of an advertisement plays upon this: the Westin Resort, Hilton Head Island, has a secluded oceanfront setting. Each of the 410 graciously appointed guest rooms and suites at the AAA 5 Diamond and Mobile 4-star rated property features its own private balcony. Cohen, Peter M. Westin Resort, Hilton Head Island World Tennis, May 91, p. 261. Hilton Head Island, on which Hilton Head, Follyfield Beach, and Forest Beach are on, is an Atlantic Coast barrier island. It has beaches on the east and tidal salt marshes with alligators on the west. It has a subtropical climate. Until the early 1950s, the island was undeveloped with second and third growth forests. Early in the 1950s, developer Charles Fraser began implementing a plan to develop the wilderness island. The island at that time was only linked by ferry to the mainland. Fraser began developing on the south end, where a community known as Sea Pines Plantation was developed. That happens to be the area where the Renaissance Week is held. Over 30-year period, the island has been developed into a world-class resort for the elite. Many of the elite have homes on lots that they own. A toll road was being built in 1992 on the island. Hilton Head Island, South Carolina, ENR, August 31, 92, page 18. Writer Roger Cox described the island as the ultimate resort playground. Roger Cox wrote two articles on Hilton Head Island for Tennis Magazine, one for the April 90 issue and one for the March 1993 issue. The recent issue talks about how the island has 300 tennis courts, a large number of golf courses, shopping malls, campgrounds, swimming pools, and many other tourist attractions for the elite. The island even has its own bank, the Hilton Head Bank and Trust, N.A. That the island, which was only forest in 1950, now has its own hank, shows that rapid development that has characterized the area since the mid-1950s. Another writer describes the island as an enchanted island. Simpson, Eileen. One Enchanted Island Travel Holiday, February 90, page 113. An advertisement offered honeymooners a 7-day honeymoon plan at the Crystal Sands Holiday Inn Crown Plaza Resort on the island for $908. There is a great demand for skilled people to service the elite's needs, and the magazine Occupational Outlook Quarterly Winter 90, page 2 plus described the benefits that went along with working the long hard shifts at Hilton Head's various hotels. Although the work days may be 12 hours long, apparently the pay and benefits are fine. The island's hotels are open 365 days a year, and work goes on 7 days a week. About 20% of the business on the island comes from conventions. The major corporations use the island a great deal. Renaissance Weekend. Perhaps the best way to describe this weekend meat market is simply to quote an article on the front page of the Wall Street Journal, Monday, December 28, 1992. The article is bylined by Wall Street Journal staff reporter James Peary, and the caption is: "Some rumors plan to greet New Year fretting over policy twee scheduled to be on hand at Renaissance Weekend are named Bill and Hillary. More than 500 carnist baby boomers, with spouses and kids in tow, are descending once again on Hilton Head, SC for New Year's Eve, and they might even pop a bottle of champagne. After all, one of them, a man who has been coming to these extended house parties for 8 years, is the next President of the United. Kiowa, Apache, and Comanche all consider the rock to be source of spiritual power. Today, Wiccans and Satanists also go to the site for spiritual power. The Comanche's spiritism had vision quests which were connected to the enchanted rock. On August 16, 1987, a harmonic convergence day was held by New Agers and Wiccans at the Rock. There is also a large granite cave called Enchanted Rock Cave at the site. The park superintendent believes that the site is sacred. His name was Warren Watson, and in 1985 he stated, "Now Enchanted Rock is a living museum with both historical and natural attractions. One of my goals is to educate the public into an attitude about Enchanted Rock State Natural Area that's different from any other state park to develop a special reverence for this place." What happened to separation of church and state? As I've said before, it appears that the U.S. government has been taking quiet steps during this century to protect and preserve occult spiritual ritual sites that are used by the witches and Satanists. Little Cypress, a suburb of Orange, Texas, is a strong point of satanic coven activity. Recruiters are going into the public schools to recruit children into Satanism. Interestingly, there is a Mormon temple in the area. Orange, Texas sits close to the Louisiana border. Smithville, Texas. This is the site of Wiccan gathering on the weekend prior to Valentine's Day. Waco, Texas, home of a satanic cult, the Circle. People in the Illuminati also will refer to it as the Circle. Utah, Bingham, UT. This is a hotbed area of Satanism, the Illuminati, and the KKK. A red brick house was used in Hingham by the KKK for child porn production and monarch programming. Their midnight ceremonial site was on the flat below Telegraph Hill near Copperfield. Celtic, Druidic, holidays are celebrated by the KKK in hooded rituals, Kennecott Copper Co. Utah. Copper Dot, in the area, is run by the Illuminati. Ehovenweep, Utah. The Hovenweep area is a series of six ancient ruins that attract witchcraft ceremonies. To get there, one can take LLS Highway 666 northwest to Pleasant View and then follow the unnumbered county road 20 miles west. There is dirt road also that comes in from Hatch Trading Post, which sits on Highway 262. Mormon temples in Utah and California. On off hours, Mormon temples are the scenes of satanic rituals which involve both Mormons and non-Mormon Satanists. Some of the higher Mormon hierarchy participate, and some of the highest Mormon hierarchy are also high in Satanism. Christians of Jeremiah films were led to entrances to the tunnels under the Salt Lake City Temple where satanic rituals are carried out. Vermont. South Royalton, Vermont, ancient Druid site containing the Druid's throne with Druid menhirs, Druid Temple with the Eye of Bel. L. South Woodstock, Vermont. Ancient Druid Temple of Bianu and a Grotto of Venus are at the site with a Mother Goddess Temple 10 miles north of South Woodstock's Temple. Virginia. Charlottesville, Virginia. The CXYCA Seminary was located here. One don't know if they still operate. Monticello, the buildings at Monticello, the home that Illuminatus and IIS Press Thomas Jefferson built, has been used for satanic rituals. Richmond, Virginia. The satanic covens operating in this city have some of the satanic heavyweights in them. Some of the covens are Illuminati covens. Barns outside of Richmond with nearby fields with bonfires have been one of the types of places the Satanists in Richmond have used for their rituals. Human sacrifices are regularly performed. I have also heard of satanic covens in Norfolk and Portsmouth. Washington. Washington is heavily saturated with New Age leaders and New Age groups. Wicca groups are very strong in the state, and Satanism is very strong. Shops like the Goddess Rising Wicca Shop on 4006 151 Avenue in Seattle supply their clients with the needed paraphernalia. During the 1950s, the West Coast Satanism was organized into a cohesive organization with ILS own hierarchy. One of the leading men in Washington state was a man named Peterson. Major meetings of the satanic hierarchy in the Washington area are planned and organized by five men, who have their own top secret planning meetings. As I understand it, these men are knighted with what is called the Five Star. Satanism is 50 secret, that meetings are not even announced over the phone. Many of the covens meet on every Friday or Saturday. The Dot in Washington and Oregon also meets on Friday. Washington State. One of the readers of this newsletter read about the Green Berets sacrificing soldiers and then remembered a recent clip, about 3 weeks ago, on Unsolved Mysteries, where the establishment media did a story on how it looked like the Green Berets in Washington had killed an army man, but that the explanation might also be suicide. It looked like to this Christian and also sounds like what was portrayed on, as an investigation was a cover-up. Turning our attention east of Seattle in the Cascades Mountains in Washington is a retreat center for a traditional English Wicca group called the Aquarian Tabernacle Church, which goes to the Washington seaside at a retreat center for their Spring Equinox Mystery Festival. Bellingham, Washington near Canada, at Bellingham, Washington near the Alaska Ferry Terminal south of some monuments Satanists have been conducting rituals. Could these be in connection with future movements of people? D.B. Boeing. Satanism is practiced at Boeing, within the Green Berets stationed in Washington, and 10 Christian churches in the Seattle area are used for satanic human sacrifices on their off hours. Satanism is infiltrated within the Mormon church in the area. Programming of Satanists, mind control, is carried out in the Boeing complex in Washington. Clear Lake, Washington, north of Snohomish near Mount Vernon, is Clear Lake, the home of the New Moon Collective of Wiccans. Fort Lewis, Washington, a 5 to 6 year power struggle between hermetic magic and ritual magic was recently patched up by the satanic hierarchy by bringing in someone from the hierarchy who lived in the Midwest. This man's name was Brian. He is approximately 48 years old, 5 foot 6 inches height, speaks English with a European accent. He is a powerful practitioner of hermetic magic. Besides unifying Satanism, a strong program to develop witchcraft and Satanism within the military has been pushed. Satanic activity in the military was discovered by M.P.S., who found out that the Green Berets in Washington had sacrificed several army men who had been missing. The whole situation was immediately covered up by the military. Elements of the Green Berets have been connected to the Illuminati since their inception, although the rank and file Green Berets were not until recent times brought into it. In other words, they have been slowly turning the Green Herets into a dangerous satanic military farce. Gifford Pinchonat. Wilderness area, Washington. Witchcraft rituals have been seen taking place in the Gifford Pinchot National Forest in the Indian Heaven Wilderness area on the plateau, at an area where the Indians in the Old West used to pather once a year for festivals and horse racing. This type of place is representative of many of the types of sites that are popular with witchcraft. If you know of any old Indian sites that have any spiritual significance, the site may well be a place used for witchcraft rituals. Snohomish, Washington. Two strong centers for Satanism are Snohomish, Washington and Yelm, Washington. Yelm, Washington is also a New Age center, where the Jay-Z Knight who channels Ramtha has her heavily guarded international headquarters, and 1,306 followers. Ramtha, Jay-Z Knight, has told her followers to study and learn all they can about the New World Order. I met a Ramtha follower who was interested in learning what I could teach on the NWO. When I tried to explain how the Illuminati uses abusive mind control and conducts human sacrifices, etc., she told me that it was my bias to quote her. She said, "It is only your opinion that these things are abuse. These people would not agree that these sacrifices are abuse." I could not get her to agree that ritual sexual abuse and human sacrifice evil and are abuse. She had been taught that she is a god, and that as a god she can do whatever she wants. Without any proper moral frame of reference, people like her in the New Age will never challenge the NWO. She is good example of how most people will never challenge the NWO because they can see only part of it, and they then go and attack themselves to some other branch of it. Jay-Z Knight's fortress-like New Age Yelm community was the site of spiritual warfare this last year by a 2 busloads of Christian young people. The Christians in that area have been under heavy spiritual attack from the heavy concentration of anti-Christian elements, and their youth director invited the Portland youth. Christians have been dying mysteriously, frequently getting sick, etc., in the area. The Christian young people prayed mightily at one site, and when they approached gate to the main community on one of the gravel roads adjacent to the land, heavily armed guards with automatic weapons appeared. Somehow the guards at the commune knew they were coming. The people did their spiritual warfare from the bus, singing mighty worship songs, and praying. It was a wonderful upbuilding experience for the Christian youth. La Pagan, Washington self-proclaimed Wiccan has built a large occult Disneyland-like complex on his property in Washington. Much of the writing on the property is in Gaelic. The place is called La Pagan. Marysville, Washington is reported to be the home of seven Wiccan covens. Up the road is Arlington, where the Love Israel group, which has connections to the Process Church. Area mountains and lakes which are sacred Indian sites are used for rituals. A Maryville which came to Christ, and the story is told, names changed, in a book. On multiple personality disorder, Stonehenge, Washington, just below the Stonehenge in Washington near Maryhill State Park, C3 and 15 and 93 newsletter, is a graveyard. This graveyard is used by the Satanists, because it is far more private than the Stonehenge, which is used by same Wiccan groups. This might be a site that someone could actually get some photos of the secret middle-level Illuminati doing rituals. The cemetery that they use is reached by going south on the road that the Stonehenge is just west of. Just a little south of the Stonehenge is a dirt road going west. Travel about 600 feet on that road and you will arrive at a cemetery. Across from the Dallas in Oregon, an exact full-size replica of Stonehenge was built in the 1920s and has been used for pagan rituals. To get there, cross the bridge at the Dallas, Oregon, into Washington. Follow US 97 until it crosses Highway 14 about 2 miles east of Maryhill Museum. Signs will direct the visitor to make a right-hand turn onto a narrow paved road. Near this Stonehenge is Maryhill Museum, built with Samuel Hill's railroad fortune and dedicated by the Queen of Romania. For some reason, the Queen of Romania was intimately connected with this site and donated items to TB Museum. The area is the scene of rituals. On the fall equinox, a Northwest Pagan Festival takes place in the area. Tacoma, Washington, a house belonging to Dr. and Rose Wilson, who has ties to Nazism, is used for satanic rituals. Rose gets instructions from the Rockefellers. Dr. Wilson was ritually killed. The house has a second basement. A small room is used to put children in during rituals. An altar of stone is used during rituals. A hospital in Tacoma is also used by this group for rituals. Washington, D.C. Washington, D.C. has a large Hispanic occult underworld and Santeria. The Santerians were at one time getting animals from Frederick, Virginia. The political world and the government agencies are constantly having parties and other occult activities. Some of the monuments around Washington, D.C. have occult significance. West Virginia. Although I know that satanic cults operate in West Virginia, I don't have specific reports of ritual sites. Moundsville, W.V. Grave Creek Mound National Historic Landmark is the site of 2,000-year-old 69-foot burial mound. Witchcraft likes to draw power from ancient burial grounds. Wisconsin. I have been informed that there was a community, a whole village of witches in Wisconsin. I suspect it may be circle near Mount Horeb. The community may number around 200. Circle is in southwestern Wisconsin. It is about 30 miles from Madison, and has 200 acres. It is near Mount Horeb. At Circle, Wiccans have their own community, with pagan marriages. Circle publishes various newsletters, a sourcebook, and helps networking among pagans. Mount Horeb also has a branch of the New Wiccan Church. About 400 pagans participate yearly in the summer solstice festival held at the Circle. Ashkelon, this was the ancient capital of an Indian culture. The site has the pyramids of the sun and moon. In honor to the sun god, ritual human sacrifices were carried out by the Indians. After the sacrifices, ritual cannibalism was participated in by the priests. The site is between Milwaukee and Madison near Lake Mills. Blue Mound's site was to become a Wiccan seminary to teach coven leadership skills and magic. This Wiccan resource center is named Our Lady of the Woods. Lizard Mounds, this is believed to be a powerful occult site built by the Indians. Large earthen effigies of things such as lizards abound in Wisconsin, and this is one of the better ones. Get on Route 144 and 4 miles northeast out of West Bend to Conti Trunk Highway A, then follow the direct markers. Madison, home of several Wiccan covens, including the Reformed Congregation of the Goddess, Milwaukee Avalon is a center for teaching paganism, magic, and rituals located in Milwaukee. Mount Horeb Pagan Spirit Alliance newsletter comes out of here. Wyoming. Jackson Hole, W.Y. Illuminati elite like to have ranches in this area. The Rockefellers have a ranch in the area, with so much Illuminati activity in the area, it is sure thing that rituals go on in the Jackson Hole area. Rawlins, W.Y. Homemade satanic covens have used areas just outside of the town. Shirley Basin, W.Y. near the ghost town of Shirley Basin in a gulch in an area called the Shirley Basin area. A satanic group has held rituals. Canada. Here are some odds and ends on ritual sites in Canada. Fruitvale, B.C. Gold is quickly melted and refined near here. Montreal, home of the satanic group CASH. Continental Association of Satan's Hope. El Quebec, Quebec. Some of the Catholic nuns and priests are secret Satanists and use their positions to aid in their satanic activities. The Catholic Church in Quebec is a major player in the acquisition of children for satanic programming and sacrifice. N.A., Red Deer, Alberta. This area of Canada has intense Illuminati activity. Toronto Druids, among others groups, are in Toronto. This metropolis is truly international, and has many different types of occult groups. Vancouver, B.C. This area is considered a spiritual vortex of power. High-level satanic rituals are conducted in the area. Windsor, ONT. This city had a strong satanic coven made up of high schoolers that were reported going 18 miles outside of the city in a woods to conduct rituals. Secret underground installations. Select top secret underground installations that threaten our liberty. Somewhere between 75 and 100 secret underground facilities have been built. Many are underground small cities. A number of these bases have been described to me by witnesses, including NORAD, Dulce, Coos Bay, and Dreamland. Format is as follows. Site name, site location, group, and groups in control, size, activity. Arizona. Fort Huachuca reported saucer base. Santa Catalina Mountains reported saucer base. Arkansas. The vicinity of Hardy and Cherokee Village reported saucer base. California. 29 Palms Marine Base reported saucer base southwest of Ludlow. This is a U.S. alien research and diagnostic facility and UFO base. Identified on military map as airspace area R2501N. Deep Springs, California reported saucer base. Fort Irwin, California reported saucer base. Edwards Air Force Base, in the area where Diamond CR and the SO. Fork of the Yuba meet, underground UFO base. George Air Force Base, reported saucer base. Hellendale, Lockheed underground facility, technology far secret projects. Los Angeles, on Highway 14 towards Edwards AFB after Palmdale, one turns off and after taking several streets to 170th Street, north on 170th Street to the Rosamond 170th intersection, the second and lower and better maintained dirt road will take you west, and if you take a right going north at the power lines and up to the hilltop, you will see the top of an underground Northo facility. Technology for the elite secret projects. Kern River, California. The hollowed out mountain next to the hydroelectric facility at the Kern River project near Bakersfield reported saucer base. Norton Air Force Base reported saucer base. Near Palmdale, if one takes Palmdale Boulevard till 240th Street and goes to Ave R-1, the eastern limit of Ave, R-8 is McDonald Augeas's facility called the Lano facility. One can see it better from the Three Sisters Hills to the south of the facility. Santa Rosa, Federal Emergency Management Agency, Cajunal Center for West Coast. What Federal Emergency Management Agency is doing is mostly kept secret. Tehachapi Ranch reported saucer base. Colorado. Alamosa reported saucer base. Colorado Springs, NORAD Canada and US, and Federal Emergency Management Agency, hundreds of people on stall, contains at least 4.5 acres of underground caverns and 15 underground steel buildings. This complex tracks thousands of satellites, missiles, submarines, and UFOs. NORAD also controls many monarch slaves who have Alex, Janus, Alexis end time callback programming. Fort Collins reported saucer base. Grand Mesa reported saucer base. Florida. Massive base reported saucer base. Eglin Air Force Base reported saucer base. Georgia. Thomasville, Federal Emergency Management Agency, Regional Center, activity unknown. Maryland. Fort Meade, below Fort Meade, National Security Agency, 10 acres of the most sophisticated supercomputers that can be built, very large complex, massive surveillance of all the world's communications, including all transmissions in the LS and in the world of telephones, telegraph, telex, fax, radio, TV and microwave transmissions. Olney, actually the facility is between Olney and Laytonsville, on Riggs Road off of Route 108. Another underground facility may also exist in the area, Federal Emergency Management Agency and possibly NSA, the facility may be 10 levels deep, purpose unknown. Massachusetts. Maynard, Federal Emergency Management Agency, Regional Center, size and activity unknown. Michigan. Battle Creek, Federal Emergency Management Agency, Regional Center, activity secret. Missouri. 12 miles south of Lebanon, near the newly created town of Twin Bridges reported saucer base. Jin the Bat and Dry and Dead Man and Howell Cluster of Caves reported saucer base. Nevada. Blue Diamond reported saucer base. Groom Lake, also known as Dreamland, Area 51. The area, the spot, Red Square, Sally Corroder, Watertown Strip. Run by the NWO along with demonic beings, the CIA is there and Wackenhut Security. Two large underground facilities close to but separate from Groom Lake but controlled by the demonic beings are Papoose K and Cockeyed Ridge, 5-4, underground bases. Purpose is the testing of various UFOs and other secret aircraft like the Aurora and Stealth. Also biological work is done, including the manufacture of small grays. Many levels have been built at these three complexes, and a 7-mile-long runway has been built over Groom Lake, a dry lake. Quartzite Mountain SE of Tonopah reported saucer base. Tonopah, Air Force, CIA. And, 7, deals with secret aircraft. New Jersey. Picatinny Arsenal reported saucer base. New Mexico. Angel Peak reported saucer base. Carlsbad Cavern area, now destroyed, reported saucer base. Dulce, New Mexico south of Dulce in the area of the G. Carilla Indian Reservation, another facility is cast of the Dulce facility a number of miles. This is run directly by Illuminati with Army and Air Force help, CIA also conduct experiments at the center, the size of the installation is huge requiring small shuttle trains and has 7 levels according to witnesses. Serves as a UFO base, biological experiments. Production center for small gray drones, Wackenhut provides some of the security on the ground. Manzano MTN, near Albuquerque, known as the Kirtland Munitions Storage Complex, Air Force, 3,000-acre base within the Kirtland Air Force Base and Sandia National Labs Complex, guarded by 4 lethal rings of fences, use unknown, suspected UFO base. A MU 285,000-square-foot bunker is being built near Manzana Base. Pytown, in area near Pytown, UFO Base. Sandia Mountains NE of Albuquerque reported saucer base. To the north of Taos Pueblo, reported saucer base. New York. Platschurg, near Canada and St. Albans, AFR reported saucer base. Oklahoma. Ada. Underground saucer base. Deep underground military bases, dumps. 140 secret underground facilities have been built, many are underground small cities. A number of these bases have been described to me by witnesses including NORAD, Dulce, Coos Bay, and Dreamland. What I am describing is a series of large underground facilities which are connected with tunnels. The tunnels carry extremely fast trains. Train terminals are up to 1 million square feet in area, with multiple levels. Underground facilities contain computer centers, genetic experimentation, mind control research, housing for several nationalities of humans and several varieties of aliens. The corporations which assist the NWO are able to quietly interlink their facilities via the tunnel system too, as well as disperse some of their workers into the world above ground. There are approximately 50 ways tunnel and underground facilities are dug, which include high-pressure continuous water jet, low-pressure percussive water jet, high-frequency electrical drill, turbine drills, pellet drills, spark drills, explosives, hydraulic rock hammers, lasers, electron beam guns, forced flames, etc. These various tunneling methods can be broken down in mechanical, such as a water cannon. Thermal, such as a high-velocity flame, laser, atomic fusion, etc., and chemical, such as a dissolver. The beautiful thing about nuclear subterranes, rhymes with submarine, is that they don't leave any debris to dispose of. These nuclear subterranes are building tunnels 40 in diameter, and as these machines work, the rock is melted into a hard, glassy tunnel lining. Air intake shafts bring fresh air to the tunnels and underground facilities. Underground facilities have fuel storage units, air conditioning, water reservoirs, dining, medical, sleeping and storage units. Many of the underground sites are close to railroads and have entrances that trucks can drive into. Some of the entrances for trucks are protected by holograms that look like the side of a mountain, but allow vehicles if one just drives through them. The other style of hidden entrances are buildings where trucks drive in and are lowered via access shafts down into the underground areas. Security for some, such as Groom Lake, of the facilities is maintained by Wacken Hut. Penetration tests on facilities are carried out by a special unit called UP-06D, which are HOD at Offutt Air Force Base, NE. Format is as follows. Site name, site location, warning, longitudes and latitudes were quick off of the head estimates, group and groups in control, size, activity. Arizona. 1. Fort Huachuca, 31,750 110 degree 19 degree 48 W, saucer base below, intelligence training above. Mind control including 2. 2. Gates Pass Base. 3. Gila Mountain Area, south of Interstate 8 and approximately 30 east of Yuma, Arizona. 29 degree N. 116 degree W deep underground military base. 4. Grand Wash Cliffs, on western edge of the cliffs at the head of Grapevine Wash. Must be reached via Highway 93 and then unpaved roads. Deep underground military base. 5. Green Valley. 6. Hualapai Mountains, east side of the mountain range, about 35 miles. SE of Kingman, Arizona. 7. Rincon Min, north side of Rincon MTN. 8. Mount Lemmon. 9. Unknown. 10. Safford, near Safford. 11. Santa Catalina Mountains, base. Arkansas. 12. In the vicinity of Hardy and Cherokee Village. 36 degree 19 91 degree 29 W installation. Purpose not known. 13. Pine Bluff, Arc area. 34 degree 13.4 and 92 degree 01.0 degree W to 34 degree 30 92 degree 30 W. Saucer Base. California. 1429 Palms Marine Base, identified on military map as airspace area R2501N. Saucer. Base southeast of Ludlow. This is a U.S. Alien Research and Diagnostic Facility and UFO base. 15. China Lake, Mind Control and Weapons Research. 16. Darwin, California, 4 miles due west of Darwin. 17. Deep Springs, 3722 and 117 degree 59.3 W saucer base. 18. Fort Irwin, California, 35720 and 1168 EW saucer base. 19. Edwards Air Force Base, in the area where Diamond CR and the SO Fork of the Yuba meet, there are 3 underground UFO bases. 3458 and 117 degree 48 W. 20. George Air Force Base, California saucer base. 21. Hellendale, Lockheed Underground Facility, 34744, 7 and 117 degree 18.5 W technology 4. Secret projects. There are 3 saucer bases here. 22. Los Angeles, on Highway 14 towards Edwards AFB after Palmdale, one turns off and after taking several streets to 170th Street, north on 170th Street to the Rosamond 170th intersection, the second and lower and better maintained dirt road will take you west, and if you take a right going north at the power lines and up to the hilltop, you will see the top of an underground Northo facility. Technology for the elite secret projects. This area was very active in the 1970s. Northrop's facility is near the Tehachapi Mints. It has been reported to go down 42 levels. It is heavily involved with electronics and high-tech aerospace research. 23. Mount Shasta. 24. Kern River, California. The hollowed-out mountain next to the hydroelectric facility at the Kern River Project near Bakersfield reported saucer base. 25. Napa Valley, located at Oakville Grade north of Napa, California. Tunnels also connect the wineries north of Napa, used for white slavery and mind control, has a saucer base. 26. Norton Air Force Base saucer base. 27. Quincy, California, 39 degree 56.27 and 120 degree 56.5 W saucer base. 28. Near Palmdale, if one takes Palmdale Boulevard till 240th Street and goes to Ave R8. 1. The eastern limit of Ave R8 is McDonnell Douglas's facility called the Lano facility. 1. Can see it better from the Three Sisters Hills to the south of the facility. Strange shaped discs raise out of the ground on pylons. These attached discs glow and change color. It is involved in high-tech aerospace technology. 29. Presidio, California, a federal emergency management agency and Dodd site for Region IX's regional office. 30. San Bernardino Co., 34 degree 50 to 34 degree 16 N. 31. Santa Barbara County, placed in the thick diatomite strata. 32. Santa Rosa, 38 degree 26.4 and 122 degree 42.9 W, Federal Emergency Management Agency, Regional Center for West Coast. What Federal Emergency Management Agency is doing is mostly kept secret. This is listed as a communications antenna field, but is doing much more. 33. Sierra Nevada Mountains, very deep military base. 34. Tehachapi Ranch, 4 saucer bases. Tekakapi Canyon has a new underground base, which was finished in September 95. This is the Unholy Six base of the Orions. 35 degree 20, 118 degree 40. 35. Trona, California, 35 degree 45.5 and 17722.66 W, several miles northwest of Trona, directly under Argus Peak. This deep underground military base sits on China Lakes NWC's land, and may have been built in the 1960s. Colorado. 36. Alamosa, 37°28.1 105°52, 2W reported saucer base. 37. Book Cliffs, 39°40 108°0 W near Rifle, Co. 38. Boulder, Co. The headquarters for EMC, a type of electromagnetic mind control that is being broadcast to modify the thinking of Americans, and to control slaves. 39. Colorado Springs, NORAD, NUS, and Federal Emergency Management Agency, hundreds of people on staff. Contains at least 4.5 cubic miles of underground caverns and 45 underground steel buildings. Many underground chambers are as large as 50x100. This complex tracks thousands of satellites, missiles, submarines, and UFOs. NORAD also controls many monarch slaves who have Alex, Janus, Alexis end time callback programming. NORAD installation has 1278 miles of road underground. 40. Fort Collins base for gray aliens. 041. Grand Mesa Orion saucer base. 42. Montrose Co. north of Paradox, in Paradox Valley. The site in Paradox Valley can be reached via Highway 90 via Nucla, Connecticut. 43. Northwest Connecticut, Florida. 44. Massive base reported saucer base. 45. Eglin Air Force Base, 30°40°N 86°50W Orion saucer base since 1978. Georgia. 46. Atlanta, Georgia Federal Emergency Management Agency Regional Center, which is appropriately placed since Atlanta is to become a capital within the NWO redrawing of boundaries. Atlanta is believed to have several underground installations in its area, one to the north at Kennesaw Mountain, Marietta, GA connected to Dobbins Air Force Base and one to the south of Atlanta at Forest Park. 47. Thomasville, 30°50.2N 83,558.47W, Federal Emergency Management Agency, Regional Center, they train groups in search and destroy missions for when martial law is imposed. This is SW Georgia in area of tunnels. Idaho. 48. Lower Goose Lake area in the general area of Oakley, ID-Wackenhut of the Illuminati run a model prison for the NWO. The worst of the federal prisoners are placed in this underground prison, which has 7,100 cells, which are filled with about 2,700 federal inmates. A track runs through the middle of the eerie underground facility. Food and showers are on the tracks, and the men are allowed showers once a week. The minimum of lighting is used, and the men are beaten senseless if they talk at all. It sits 500 underground. 49. South Central Idaho under the Snake River lava flows between Twin Falls and Idaho Falls, Indiana. 50. Bedford and Lawrence Co. area continued activity in large old mines indicates a possible government use of the large old quarries. Kansas. 51. Atchison, Kansas the DIPEF underground facility, which the government would run in an emergency. AT&T maintains an underground facility at Fairview, Kansas. 52. Kinsley an underground UFO base. Maryland. 53. Camp David just north of the camp is an underground facility important to the intelligence agencies. 54 below Fort Meade, of the National Security Agency, 10 acres of the most sophisticated supercomputers that can be built, very large complex, massive surveillance of all the world's communications, including all transmissions in the US and world of telephones, telegraph, telex, fax, radio, TV and microwave transmissions. 55. Olney, Actually, the facility is between Olney and Laytonsville, on Riggs Road off of Route 108. Another underground facility may also exist in the area, Federal Emergency Management Agency and possibly NSA, the facility may be 10 levels deep, purpose unknown. 56. Suitland, Maryland. Classified archives of U.S. government stored here in underground levels. Vaults have extensive amounts of documents which are not indexed. Restricted access with a coded security card. High-level intelligence groups operate in the area also. Massachusetts. 57. Maynard, 42 degree 26.07127.0 W. Federal Emergency Management Agency, Regional Center, Wackenhut is here too. Michigan. 58. Battle Creek, 42 degree 19.51N85 degree 10.9 W. Federal Emergency Management Agency, Regional Center, Activity Secret, Not Validated. 59. Gwin, Michigan, 46 degree 16.8N87 degree 26.5 W. Near Gwin is a large underground base which is a key base for sending signals. An Air Force base is also nearby. Under Lake Superior is an alien base with roads 5,000 deep. Missouri. 60. 12 miles south of Lebanon, 36 degree 02.8 115 degree 24.3 W, near the newly created town of Twin Bridges, reported saucer base. 001. In the Bat and Dry and Dead Man and Howell cluster of caves, reported saucer base. 62. St. Francis Mountains, Missouri, between St. Louis and New Madrid, Nebraska. 63. North Central Nebraska. 64. Red Willow Co. near McCook, N.E., Nevada. 65. Blue Diamond, 36 degree 02.8N115724.3 W, reported saucer base. 66-68. Groom Lake, also known as Dreamland, Area 51. The area, the spot, Red Square. Sally Corroder, Watertown Strip. 115 degree 50N37 degree 20 W, run by the NWO along with demonic beings, the CIA is there, and Wackenhut security. Two large underground facilities close to, but separate from Groom Lake but controlled by the demonic beings, are Papoose Range and Cockeyed Ridge, 5-4, underground bases. Purpose is the testing of various UFOs and other secret aircraft like the Aurora and Stealth. Also biological work is done, including the biological raising of small greys. Many levels have been built at these three complexes, and a 7-mile-long runway, which is actually 39 miles, has been built over Groom Lake, a dry lake. There is an S2, an S4, an S6, and an S66 underground installations. S66 is the most secret, and it has 29 levels and is 11,300 feet deep. 69. Quartzite Mountain, SE of Tonopah, 37 degree 3N 116 degree 20 degree W, reported saucer base. 70. Tonopah, Air Force, CIA and unknown deals with secret aircraft. New Hampshire. 71-73. There may be as many as three underground installations in New Hampshire's hills, according to reports. New Jersey. 74. Picatinny Arsenal, 40 degree 3N8N74 degree 32 degree W, saucer base, 1N4 cubic mile, large and very deep underground. New Mexico. The state of New Mexico and Colorado have been used for the construction of a series of underground bases. All the rest of the states have too. The primary underground facilities in New Mexico consist of three enormous underground bases in the Dulce, New Mexico area, an area I spent several days investigating in 1993. The White Sands Alamogordo area, which has three underground bases, and Pi Town, which have two more underground bases. Carlsbad Cavern, which had underground activity, which is reported discontinued, and another base to east of Carlsbad. The Los Alamos Area Underground Facility. The Taos Area Underground Facility. The New Mexico area has basically four underground system out. One goes to the Four Corners area and then to Groom Lake, Area 51. One goes north toward Delta Colorado and Colorado Springs. The Taos facilities goes north approximately along Interstate 25 and eventually ties in NORAD. The southern bases connect to Texas and Mexico. The Los Alamos facility dates at least back to 1940, one can only imagine what has been built with one and two century of labor on this underground system. Visitors to the deeper levels report humans kept in glass cylinders, plus many other strange things. I have had the opportunity to debrief some people who have been in the lower reaches of some of these facilities. There are special badges, special uniforms, tube elevators, etc., which for lack of time I will not describe. 77. Angel Peak reported saucer base. Carlsbad Cavern area, now destroyed, 32 degree 25.0 degree and 104 degree 14.0 W. Old relics of saucer base. Left. 78 to 80. Dulce, NM, 36 degree 56.0 and 106759.8 W, south of Dulce, in the area of the G. Carilla Indian Reservation, another facility is cast of the Dulce facility a number of miles. This is run directly by Illuminati with Army and Air Force help. CIA also conduct experiments at the center. The size of the installation is huge, requiring small shuttle trains, and has seven levels. According to witnesses, serves as UFO base, biological experiments, production center for small gray drones. Wacken Hut provides some of the security on the ground. 81. Kirtland Air Force Base, New Mexico, Sandia National Lab. Manzano MTN, near Albuquerque, known as the Kirtland Munitions Storage Complex. Air Force, 3,000-acre base within the Kirtland Air Force Base and Sandia National Labs complex, guarded by four lethal rings of fences, use unknown, suspected UFO base. A new 285,000-square-foot bunker is being built near Manzano Base. 83. I-Town, 34 degree 17.9 degree 10808.7 W, in area near Pi Town, UFO base. 84. Sandia Mountains NE of Albuquerque reported saucer base. To the north of Taos Pueblo, reported saucer base. 85. White Sands, 32722.8 and 106728.8 W, major hub for research, tied in with Dulce and NORAD. New York. Adirondack Mountains, near Elizabethtown. New York metro area. Plattsburgh, near Canada and St. Albans, 49 degree 40 degree and 73 degree 33 W. 2 saucer bases. This area. Oklahoma. 36. Ada, 3,446. 44 and 967,407 W, underground saucer base. This base does human cloning, and it is the Federal Emergency Management Agency's most sensitive base. 87. Ashland Naval Ammunition Depot, 3,445.9 and 96 degree 04.3 W, reported saucer base. Oregon. Bull Run, north side of Bull Run Reservoir area near Mount Hood, and very close to Larch Mountain and south of Benson Street Park of the Columbia Gorge. Kuzbi area has had three separate but coordinating underground facilities built for UFOs. The facility farthest east, about 20 miles inland in the wilderness near Highway 42, has been shut down. It is has an old abandoned facility well camouflaged. The coast facility is probably still operational. Klamath Falls, Oregon. Since September 95, this has been a base for a number of NWO groups, including the Air National Guard, Federal Emergency Management Agency, CIA, FBI, Spetsnaz, and MOSAP training base. An underground concentration camp exists here. Pennsylvania. Blue Ridge Summit, near Fort Ritchie, known as Raven Rock Ore Site, Army. Major electronic nerve center, 650 feet below surface with about 350 staff and over a 716-acre area, possibly connected via tunnel to Camp David. Texas. Fort Hood. Texas, 31°15°97°48°W. Home of some Delta mind-controlled soldiers and a reported saucer base. Denton. Texas, Federal Emergency Management Agency, Regional Center, Activity Secret. Red River Arsenal. Texas. Reported saucer base. Virginia. Bluemont, Mount Weather Base, Federal Preparedness Agency and Federal Emergency Management Agency. Small City Underground, Top Secret, staff of several hundred, does secret work for Federal Emergency Management Agency and contains a complete secret government with the various agencies and cabinet-level ranking administrators that keep their positions for several administrations and help run the United States. Culpeper, 38°28.57759.8W, about 2 miles east of Culpeper off of Route 3. Called Mount Pony, Illuminati Fed Reserve, 140,000 square foot, includes a facility for the storage for corpses, monitors all major financial transactions in the U.S. by means of the Fed Wire, a modern electronic system. The Pentagon, Arlington, Virginia. Warrington Training Center, two sites, one on Route 802 and the other on Bear Wallow Road, on Viewtree Mountain. One is Station A, the other Station B. Army and unknown, purpose unknown. Washington. Bothell, Federal Emergency Management Agency, Regional Center, activity unknown. Washington, D.C. The White House. The secret NOD underground installation, which is connected to the intelligence groups like NSA and the CIA as well as many other nefarious groups, lays under the White House with tunnels connecting this NOD installation with the House of the Temple. The Supreme Council of the 33 degree of the Scottish Rite's House of the Temple has a 14 feet by 25 feet room in it with 13 chairs where the Illuminati's Grand Druid Council meet. The NOD deep underground installation has numerous levels to it. One eyewitness went to level 17 via an elevator and stated that he believes that deeper levels exist. The NOD installation is involved with psychic, demonic, and satellite control over slaves. This underground complex is to allow the government of the United States to escape a nuclear attack. The enormous complex radiates under Washington, D.C. and connects with many other sites. The tunnel system is used to move some of the mind-control sex slaves. The walls and ceilings of the tunnels are ceramic tile with fluorescent lighting recessed into the ceilings. West Virginia. Sugar Grove, the Navy's Office of Naval Strategic Intelligence Services monitors U.S. microwave communications. There is also a saucer base here. White Sulphur Springs, under the Greenbrier Hotel, a mini city large enough for 800 people, equipped with its own crematorium. If there are any other purposes other than listening to U.S. microwave communication, it is unknown by this author. Ashland Naval Ammunition Depot, reported saucer base. Pennsylvania. Blue Ridge Summit, near Fort Ritchie, known as Raven Rock or Site K, Army, Major Electronic Nerve Center, 650 feet below surface with about 350 staff and over a 716-acre area. Possibly connected via tunnel to Camp David, Virginia. Bluemont, Mount Weather Base, Federal Preparedness Agency and Federal Emergency Management Agency. Small city underground, top secret, staff of several hundred, does secret work for the Federal Emergency Management Agency and contains a complete secret government with the various agencies and cabinet-level ranking administrators that keep their positions for several administrations and help run the United States. Culpeper, about 2 miles east of Culpeper off of Route J, called Mount Pony, Illuminati. Federal Reserve, 140,000 square feet, includes a facility for the storage for corpses, monitors all major financial transactions in the U.S. by means of the Fedwire, a modern electronic system. Warrington Training Center. Two sites are on Route 802 and the other on Bear Wallow Road, on Viewtree Mountain. One is Station A, the other Station B, Army and 77, purpose unknown. Major mind control programming sites. Organizations practicing trauma-based mind control. Air Force Intelligence. Army Intelligence. Atomic Energy Commission. Boeing. British Intelligence, including MI6, MI5, and IHE Tavistock Institute. Bureau of Prisons. Catholic Church. Central Intelligence Agency CIA Service. Club 12 and Club 41. Country Music Industry. Defense Intelligence Agency Department of Justice. Federal Bureau of Investigation. Freemasonry. Japan. German Intelligence, Shabak, GHG. Hollywood. The House of Saud in Saudi Arabia. The Illuminati at all levels are involved in trauma-based mind control as perpetrators and victims. INS. Ku Klux Klan, different KKK groups, Los Angeles Dodgers. Mossad. Mormon Church. National Security Agency NSA. National Programs Office. Naval Intelligence, ONI. OTA. Palo Mayombe. Process Church and its offshoot. Ching Unit. Professional baseball, such as the LA Dodgers. Russian government and intelligence groups. Santaria. Satanic Hubs. Temple of Power, previously known as Temple of Set. Umbanda. U.S. Army ESP. The Delta Forces and the 1st Earth Battalion. VSAF. Werewolf Order. Some witchcraft groups besides Satanism and the Illuminati.